How easy is it to overlook trailblazers? To take for granted opportunities they struggled to obtain? To walk through doors they first opened? To underestimate their strength? One such trailblazer is Kathy Kuzner. Kuzner grew up in a Virginia and Maryland landscape filled with horses. After seeing a horse show as a little kid, she was hooked.
First of all, I found a pony in somebody's backyard, and it had a for sale sign. And it was $150, and it had a Western saddle and a bridle and a bag of feed and all of this for $150. And I ran home and I said to my parents, "This will shut me up."
A quick learner with a natural affinity for horses, she was noticed and given mounts to ride and show. While still in high school, her love of horses took her beyond the show ring to ride in unrecognized flat races and over timber courses. In 1958, at age 18, she was invited to the United States Equestrian Team Trials, and by 1961, became a riding member of the team. In 1960, she was recognized by the American Horse Shows Association as Horsewoman of the Year. Kathy's first Washington appearance at the inaugural event in 1958 was almost derailed.
I was so excited to get down here so fast, immediately, now, and I went through a red light and totaled my car.
Still, she competed and won her first of many classes at Washington. She joined the prestigious ranks of President's Cup winners in 1962, aboard Unusual. Another time, Kuzner catch rode a shaggy horse named Sky High in the Sky High High Jump, winning at 6'7". Perhaps the most unique Washington riding performance belongs to Kuzner for the 1968 Disney movie, The Horse in the Gray Flannel Suit. She was filmed during the show on Aberali to stand in for the film star. Kuzner was part of the gold medal team at the 1963 San Paulo Pan Am Games and the silver medal team at the 1967 Winnipeg Games. The first of her three Olympics was Tokyo 1964, followed by Mexico City 1968, and in 1972, she became the first American woman to bring home an equestrian medal as part of Team Silver in Munich. She twice won the Puissance at Aachen at 6'7" on Untouchable and at 7'3" on Aberali, among many triumphs throughout Europe. Though she'd been a successful jockey in unrecognized races, Kuzner knew she would hit a wall when she tried to get a jockey's license from the Maryland Racing Commission in 1967. She was denied because she was female. Using the 1964 Civil Rights Act, she challenged her denial in court.
It took about 3 minutes, and he just took his hammer and said, "Boom, you cannot deny this person a jock's license." So I had a jock's license.
Her perseverance eventually took her to races around the world. She also became the first woman to ride in the Maryland Hunt Cup, the toughest timber race there is. After seeing the detrimental effects of segregation as a teenager, in 1999, Kuzner founded Horses in the Hood, which brings at-risk youth from South Central Los Angeles to five-day camps where they learn responsibility, acquire communication skills, and build emotional bonds through working with horses. For her efforts, she was inducted into the World Sports Humanitarian Hall of Fame. She is a licensed commercial pilot, type-rated in Learjets, flies seaplanes and gliders, and has acrobatic skills. In 1997, at the age of 57, she ran a 100-mile race in just over 27 hours. Called a perfect jumper rider, Kuzner appreciated her horses for the pure enjoyment they gave her, not for the accolades and honors. It was about the joy of it all, she said. The rest was a byproduct. It's quite a collection of byproducts. With great pleasure, we welcome Kathy Kuzner into the Washington International Horse Show Hall of Fame.